Just do that one step towards this amazing thing that you have in your brain. Because remember, there is not another person just like you who will have this idea, this desire, this the incredible thoughts and creativity. Welcome to a new episode of the Eva Eckert podcast. And today's title is You Are Limitless. For those of you who are here the first time, I am Eva Eckert. I am host of this show. I am a Polish immigrant with a big heart, strong accent, as you can hear, kick-ass husband and two beautiful kids. American entrepreneur sharing an incredible mission to inspire women around the world to take bold actions towards their dreams, passions, desires, so finally their life becomes meaningful and fulfilled. I believe that the badass superhero of your unique purpose is within all of you, all of us, and we should share it with the world to make the world a better place. This show will help you finally discover the power of self-belief and self-motivation so you can stop making excuses and create the life you truly desire and deserve by being the best version and upgraded version of you. Welcome to the show, guys. So we're always starting with the gratitude. What is your gratitude today? It's not only about me. This show is about you. I am just the messenger. I'm just the messenger here. So write it down. What is the gratitude? If this is your first time, you maybe never heard these episodes ever before. So my gratitude always goes to my family, but today specifically to my kids for really creating an incredible garage sale that we're gonna have in the upcoming weeks, and also for my family to working super hard for the upcoming webinar, which is happening January 6th, 2024. Gratitude goes towards all of you guys because for you being here, and for those of you who are already signed up for the free webinar that we have. But we're going to talk about this later because the title of this episode is You Are Limitless. And I'm going to take you on the ride on the journey with me to inspire you to create your dreams, create the dreams that you have, your reality. And I started, and I talk about this, my event, the Freak Female Alliiance event. It was created out of just passion, desire, a thought, and actually it's an event. So I started last year in 2023, and I already have two classes of the event. And the reason that I wanted to mention this event is because there is a lot of lessons. So where you actually start working on something, it's become a bigger version each time you work on something. It's becoming a different thing that when you start working on something. It represents you, your ideas, your passions, your desires. And my idea for today's episode, as it always is to inspire you. So if you have a dream, that nagging feeling in your stomach, in your gut, that you want to do something, I want you to grab paper and pen today and start writing this dream. I want you to connect to that special superpower that you have and create something that will be the voice of you. Not necessarily this has to be an event. It can be anything, but please just do. Just do that one step towards this amazing thing that you have in your brain. Because remember, there is not another person just like you who will have this idea, this desire, this the incredible thoughts and creativity. And the world will miss out on something special. And with this world that is happening around us, this fast pace, we need to have a moment of clarity. We need to think, what am I here for? And this is a perfect, really, episode for the beginning of the year, right? What are you here for? What is your desire? What is your calling? And for me, that calling was that event. And when I look in my journals, what I was writing was exactly what I did last year. Meaning, I was writing that I want to have an event for women. In the beginning, it was like events. Like, I was not clear about it. Like, events, maybe with my husband. You know, then it went into events only for women. And I did it. So, when you start working on something, this vision that you have today, it's not going to be what it's going to be, the final vision. This thing will be constantly being transformed. And I just wanted to tell you, because sometimes you have a thing and you think that maybe this thing is not ready, or maybe you just need to work on it more to release it. But where you are with what you have is perfect right there. Because what I did, I started very small. There were just two events. So I started very small. And after each event, I would took the time to think about it, to get a feedback from others. And I'm going to be telling you this in detail, to think about it. How can I improve? What I can do better? And it takes time with everything, because sometimes we just want to, like, to get it done, to be over with, but we're missing on that joy. We're missing on that journey. And journey should be really experienced by you. And this is the beauty of it all. When I was actually writing this episode today, preparing for this episode, and I was typing these lessons, and I'm like, wow. I copy what I wrote and I put it exactly in my file of the Freak Female Alliiance, the business that literally is like a separate business that I created, because it's step by step what I've done. And this is another point for you. Whatever you do, start creating those things in your Google Drive file. Start being organized. Don't put it on a piece of paper. Don't put it on your notebook. You need to start being organized. And some people will tell me, well, you know, but I like to journal in my notebook. Yes, good. But when you type something, when you create, do it on your computer, because you can build a business from scratch, and it might take you years, but you need to have tools and steps when you start it. And that's what I did. And the more work I was putting into it, and I actually look at this today and I'm like, God, I created a totally new business, a totally new idea that came out of just working on it. So guys, another point, when you're working on something, again, store this stuff in your Google Drive, be organized. So you're going to have like steps that you can track back, that you can look and see, okay, this is what I did. Because if I didn't do that, I would not have the resources and the feedback that I got from my first event. You know, I've learned so much about me from these events, meaning like, what do I like? What do I dislike? What is that I'm passionate about? Like in the second event, for instance, I added dance. I added yoga nidra, because this dance, the idea of a dance, of having a dance class, dance instructor was sitting with me for a long time. And in a first event, I couldn't find an instructor. And this nagging, the God shows up, and the God thing was like, you need to have a dance instructor. You need to do this. And that's what I go for it. I went for it and I found it, because I took the time to search. I took the time to put the mission out there. I put the time to spread to the universe. And I think that's the magic. And the magic, it's not just people say, oh, it just happens. The magic is the hard work. Remember, your magic is your hard work. And you need to put that work. So again, I've learned so much about myself. It's just because I was taking the time to really reflect and think about it, right? So my first event versus the second event, they were completely two different events, because the first event was just a day and the second event was day and a half. And when I was looking into my first event, I'm like, God, this was too much. It was too much on a go-go. And when I was getting feedback from this event, it was the same thing. The women were saying, you know, it was amazing. It was such a breakthrough for us, but it was just so much information packed in one thing that I'm like, okay, let me do an event of day and a half. So in a second event, we met earlier the night before and we had a chat to enough time to mingle, to chat, to do fun exercises that I plan with the girls so they get to know each other. And the reason for it is because women connect with women after they get to know each other, that we can open up and be vulnerable and trust someone after connecting with that person. If you know what I'm saying, if you are a girl, you know what I'm talking about, right? Because sometimes it just feels awkward, especially that we have in our workshop, in the Freak Female Alliiance workshop, you have the part of vulnerability. You have to dive deeper and share. And how can you share with someone if you don't know that person? And I'm not saying that you're going to get to know them in such a deep level like you have your friends, right? But through these exercises and having the fun time and the yoga nidra time and other things, it's going to open up the next level of connections, because I've learned also that the breath work, turning into breath, deep breath work, is really opening up another sense in you, another level in you, another connecting level with yourself and with others. And guys, I'm speaking this and I'm saying this about this event because you're gonna be learning about yourself when you're gonna be doing these things that really make you happy. These things that are sitting in your head and nobody knows about it. So maybe it's time to start drawing the plan, to start dumping these ideas and going with a little plan to how can you achieve them. And I'm saying this because, again, from just my brain, my idea came to fruition as actual event. What else I've learned besides the fact how I know how women connect? And it was, again, it was from feedback, but it was also from me studying and learning about how women work, how women connect, what is important to them, right? And that's why I add these parts. I've learned so much about running a workshop, and I'm not saying that I didn't in running presentations. I'm not saying that I've never done a presentation, because when we had our bootcamp and boxing locations, we run these presentations. And again, more and more of these presentations we would do, more and more we would add to these presentations. And by the way, actually, my husband was the one that would run mostly of these presentations, because he felt like obligated that he is the one to speak, and I would maybe just do an intro or help him with something. And always inside of me was that urge to speak, to have a voice, because I am from another country. And if I can achieve what I've achieved, you can achieve anything. If you are American and maybe you are speaking right now to an American audience, or maybe, you know, I'm here in America, I'm here in another country. So that's what it's like. I'm trying to show you that maybe you are an immigrant from another country and you see me speaking and you see me being successful. You're thinking like, oh, if she did it, I can do it. And you can. That's what I wanted to tell you. It's you can. You just need to replace the fear, the doubt, with faith and belief. That's what it is. It's just flipping. Always remembering that on the side of one coin, there is another side. That there are two sides always. And once, this is like good and bad, right? Even though we shouldn't name those things, but I think if we're gonna believe that something like this exists, we're gonna act towards it. So me actually doing these workshops and doing my own presentations allowed me to speak my voice. And I always wanted to do that. My dream was to do that. And my dream was always like, how can I, you know, be on stage and speak? How can I show my voice? How can I show my presentations? How can I inspire people? And I put this message out to the universe. And in 2023, for the first time, besides me actually doing these events, I was asked by a big company to speak in their events in Idaho. And I cannot tell you guys how thrilled I was, but I also talk about this in my previous episode. I was like, holy smoke, what have I just done? Because here's the thing, you want something, you ask for that thing, and the thing comes to you. And then you've realized, it's like, oh my God, this is so out of my comfort, so out of control, so out of my comfort zone, we know this term, so out of reach, so out of what I know and what I feel comfortable with. And this is where the moment of growth is coming. And I talk about this in details, how I did it and what I did. So I don't want to really jump into it and repeat what I did. But it's just happened for me. And I thought, what an incredible thing is to speak at other events, but also what an incredible thing is to speak at my own events, because this is my event. I can, you know, it's just a different feeling, right? So the way how I was running first workout was totally different than I was running the second workshop and the second event, because I felt more comfortable, even though I had different women. And here is another thing that I've learned, that each of my event will be different. They will never be the same events. And simply because I would have to, think about it. If this is the same event, if I'm running the same event, I can't sell it to the same audience, because you have to always reach for a new audience, right? Different event, I can also advertise in the same audience. And it's time for some drink, guys. Delicious. So it was like, boom, I can't have the same. So everything has to be different. I'm not saying that certain things, little things can be repeat, but my goal is to always have it different. And look, maybe for you will be something like, from this episode, you're going to be thinking, I'm going to start doing events, or I want to do something. You have to do something and then write your lessons from that thing. And ask yourself, how can I improve? What can I change? What can be better, right? What can be different? For me also was, you know, sticking to the time and agenda that I have. Because in the first one, I was kind of allowing people to change the time a little bit because of the fact that maybe they were not on time. Here I was like, no, how I'm going to stick to the agenda, announce earlier, tell people what's coming, right? That this is, and this time, how much time we have for certain things, right? Announcing, being more clear. So the clarity came for me. Also the meals, what meals should I have? What meals should not have? And the meals were kind of like, oh, okay, what can I do? I can have a sponsor for the meals. How wonderful to have somebody that is actually sponsoring this event. So you see, all these ideas are coming to you because you're working on it. And then you're thinking, okay, well, who I can connect? So another thing is connection. Like, who I can connect? Who is in my proximity that will benefit and add value to my event? And let me tell you, connection to like-minded women is nothing more than a gift here, because being a part of different events, you're going to be connecting with these incredible women. And that's what I did. Over the course of 2023, I've met incredible women with incredible values, incredible knowledge. And this is what you need in your life, whatever is there that you're planning. I've learned so much about affiliates. And here's another thing, that this will be big for a lot of things that are coming in 2024, because you want others to promote your things. You want others to be involved, but how can they promote something without nothing? So I've learned not only how to choose, how to manage and the expectations that I've had. I've learned much more about the affiliates, you know, the recognition and how they have to be paid. And when I first did the first event, it was just quick. The second I was like, okay, I need to have a Zoom. I need to communicate with them. I need to set certain things before. But then after this actual Zoom, I thought, well, this should have been totally different. So now, based on what I've learned, I prepare my file to when I'm going to be actually meeting with my affiliates. I put a little bit more time to it based on how affiliates were and how they were performing. I've learned what needs to be done, how my expectations have to be clear, more, what they will be getting, what they can do themselves. And this is all a learning process. So with this, I just wanted to tell you that you're going to make mistakes, because with the affiliates, I made many mistakes, even with the last ones, because I believe that I wasn't clear enough of my expectations. If I was clear what to expect every single day, what they should be doing, I think the outcome would be much better. And also, you need to think about people and choose people that are high performance. That people, because sometimes, you know, you create something and you think because you create it, because this is your thing, you think that people will be doing the same thing. But oh boy, you can't be wrong. Because how can you get people that will understand the value that you give on the same level as you are? How can you? Well, of course, you can do it with the pay. You can give them percentage of your product, what you're launching, what are you doing, but you also can show expectations. You can raise them to a level that you are. But sometimes it's gonna be very hard. Sometimes you're gonna think, because maybe they are your friends, people that you've met and you wanna help so bad, that you think that putting them on a really high level, that it's gonna raise them up to that high level. But sometimes this won't work too. So I've learned so much about this, that the best way to choose the affiliates are to where you know someone that this person will perform on as high level as you are. So again, you need to make these mistakes, guys, to be able to see what you shouldn't be doing or what you should be doing. And again, it takes time to really reflect and think about it. This is not a fast thing. So I'm just pointing these things that I've learned. I've learned about the price mistake. You know, the first event was higher than the lower event. Then the deadline. Always you need to have a deadline. And we set up the deadline more with the second event than with the first one. But I also learned that the event has to be advertised much earlier. And you need to have the VIP package for people and advertise more and get them to reserve that spot more earlier and keep on telling people that each store, each feed, each post, each email is CTA, call to action. Call to action is with everything. Sharing the stories and showing them any ideas, what's coming, what speakers and things like that. Yes, but call to action always. Because sometimes we forget about this. And you know, for those of you that maybe don't know the terms, that's why I'm explaining it to you. After the first one, I did a feedback and I actually got on the phone with women. But the second one, I came with a totally different idea of a feedback, of actually a homework that they need to do it right on the spot, that they need to record this video, that they need to send me an email. So more and more I'm working on it, more and more ideas I'm coming with. And I had live testimonials. I have live case studies. And this is golden. Also, after the second event, I realized, you know, I need a different Instagram for it. I need to create a community because it's all going to be about the events. I want to separate these things. I don't need to have this all on my personal feed as a coach, right? As a one-on-one operate to dominate high performance coach, I wanted to have like a separate Instagram account just for this Freak Female Alliiance events, not even group coaching, just events, because obviously I'm not going to be posting things that we discuss in our group, because this is a secret stuff. Unless somebody allows me and say, you know, I agree to this, we can post this, then sharing, because we share a lot of different, very intimate things. You know, feedback, when I've asked for the feedback the second time, also my questions were aligned. I've had better questions. I have a set of questions. What did you like? What did you dislike? What would you improve? Who would you suggest this event to? What you got out of this? What was the most three things that you're gonna implement right now at this moment? So guys, again, breakthroughs for me, but breakthroughs for women. And I know that this is going to be an amazing, a big thing, because I'm working on it. I'm working on it big time, guys. And it's coming up this year. And it's just there in my head. It's just incredible how the whole picture is being drawn. And I am super excited, because how can I not be excited about something that I'm passionately involved, right, with? And that's the beauty of it. That's when you start feeling like you are authentic to your own self. So you got to start creating the things that make you happy. And that's the beauty of it. So, you know, another breakthrough for me was when I was thinking what people need versus what they crave. And I'm not talking about the need that they need from themselves. I need this. It's almost like from the outside source, what I think that they should, because I see it. I see it, what they doing. So for instance, the good food, people crave unhealthy foods, but we need to give them healthy food. So they craving unhealthy, but they should be eating healthy. And even at this event, I mean, I've had people asking certain things, what is the bacon for breakfast? And I'm like, you would never see bacon in this house for breakfast, because this is not what we do.
They never see bacon at all.
So you're going to be served the healthy snacks, protein shakes, protein bars, salad with chicken, maybe with fish, you know. And we've done something super cool, because me and my daughter, we created charcuterie board. And by the way, I went on YouTube today and I found a cool guy, he is French, that he explains to you the pronunciation of certain French words. It was so cool. And he was saying, like, you should underline the charcuterie, like the U, that American pronunciation is different. But anyway, I had to drill this into my head for a long time, how I'm saying charcuterie. And we had fun with my daughter. We bought all kinds of cheeses and all kinds of meat. And this was per standards, per Freak Family standards, that would be on the unhealthy sides. Because we don't really eat cheese. We don't really consume cheeses in such quantities as we put it out there, or any other kind of meat. But because my dream was always to do that, we just had a fun with it. And since my daughter is, and my son is homeschooled, we just had fun with this, right? And so what else? What else the women learned? They learned, and those are their words, we've learned consistency. The consistency is the key. Showing up for, not for only for yourself, but for others. To let go of so many things. That we are, you are limitless. The discipline, the urgency, the woman's tribe. That women need a tribe. They need someone that will inspire them, that will push them to the next level. And you know, some women were asking, well, you know, how about we're gonna be putting a name tags on our shirts? And this was one of the feedbacks. And here's the thing. Thank you for this, but we are not in kindergarten. So we wouldn't have the name tags. Because I think that each of us, and this is a partial of partial learning of emotional intelligence, that you should learn people's names. You should be on that level when you meet someone that you actually repeat this name 3 times so it stick to your head so you can communicate with them. And this is again a challenge, because this Freak Female Alliiance event is about challenging you. It's about showing you the zone of genius and also the zone of weakness. And I am, some speakers, I've learned this, some people saying this, you should be working on only on your zone of greatness, always leave the zone of weakness. But I don't believe in that, because if you are overweight and you don't eat good, that's your weakness. So you're not going to work on it. So the end of your life, you're going to be overweight and you're going to be unhealthy. No, work on a zone of weakness. Push your zone of greatness, but also make yourself better, right? And I've learned that we all have the multidimensional side of us, that we are, as women, we can have this genuine, delicate, beautiful, flowing side of us. But also we can have this masculine side, that we can have that strength. We have that purity and the strong part of, for instance, going into an ice bath, of doing these hard workouts. That's the beauty of it. And I think sometimes as women, we forget, we go into one side and we forget about that it's the other side. So that's what Freak Female Alliiance is all about. It's all about creating the well-rounded you, the woman that is strong, that is powerful, that is also soft and genuine and gentle. Like, remember, like the coin has these two sides. And we've learned how we do one thing is how we do everything. Always Pedro Skoulians talks about this. You know, treat your life like the workout. Go and do hard shit. Go and push yourself harder. Go and stretch yourself. Don't procrastinate. And this is how you become limitless. And I think this is a perfect episode for the upcoming year, guys. And with the end of this episode, I just wanna to invite you again. January 6th, we have this amazing Zoom call, how to dominate your life, how to dominate your day in 2024. And for those of you who haven't registered yet, please text Domination Day to 909-749-8782. Again, text Domination Day to 909-749-8782 so you can receive the Zoom link. The email is required, so you can text us the email to this number. We will be waiting for you. You guys gonna get the Zoom link. Again, the registration link will also be below on this episode. And of course, please follow the Freak Female Alliiance on Instagram. And if you have any questions, if you ever want to submit any questions for these upcoming episodes, please send me an email into eva.peakphysique@gmail.com. I would love to hear from you guys, because these episodes are for you, not for me. They're for you. I'm here for you, to help you and inspire you. And just remember that the superhero is within you. You just need to reconnect with your innate force. You just need to discover it. May your discipline, energy, and confidence be unstoppable. May your passion and curiosity be endless. May your enthusiasm be infectious. Your inner glow shine through the projects and your creations. And may your final outcome be of service to others. Each of us makes a difference in the universe. I make mine. Now the time is for you. No excuses, guys.